Dr. Sang-Ki Kim is the technical director at Vexcell Biotherapeutics. He is currently also a professor at the Department of Companion and Laboratory Animal Science at Gongju National University. Dr. Kim is also a research associate in the Research Center for Cancer Immunotherapy at the Chonam National University Wasun Hospital. So please, Dr. Kim, you will have a presentation on a very important topic, which is NK cell based cancer immunotherapy in dogs on Vexloquin 15. So let's welcome our dear speaker, Dr. Sang-Ki Kim.
Okay, so thank you very much. And I would like to thank all the organizers who invite me today. And as Chair mentioned just before, my today's topic is about NK cell-based immunotherapy in dogs using Vexloquin 15. Vexloquin 15 is recombinant canine interleukin 15. The annual incidence of cancer in dogs is strikingly higher than it is in humans. And the range of cancers observed in dogs is known to be as diverse as that observed in humans. More specifically, dogs are twice as likely to develop leukemia than humans, four times more likely to suffer from breast cancers, eight times more likely to develop bone cancers, and an incredible 35 times more at risk for developing skin cancers. Cancers in dogs share many features with human cancers, including histological appearance, tumor genetics, molecular targets, biological behaviors, and many conventional therapies applied to canine patients, such as surgery, chemotherapy, radiation therapies, are nearly identical to those used to treat human patients. Especially, the response to therapies are same as in humans. However, all of these conventional therapies have low accumulates serious side effects and high relapse and metastatic rates. Recently, immunotherapy using immune cells like T cells, dendritic cells, NK cells, and target antibodies, immune checkpoint inhibitors emerged as an important new generation of cancer therapies. So in human medicine, NK cells have become a central focus for engaging the immune system in the fight against cancers. So for the first 15 years, we have been working on the development of cancer immunotherapy using canine NK cells in dogs. NK cells are effector lymphocytes of innate immune system, which play an important role on controlling viral infection and tumor development. NK cells exert their effector functions by direct killing of cancer cells or virus-infected cells, and by secreting a variety of cytokines and chemokines. Unlike T cells, NK cells do not require the presence of a specific antigen for the recognition of abnormal target cells. Furthermore, recent studies have shown that NK cells demonstrate immune memory functions, which is a feature of adaptive immune system cell populations. So for NK cell-based cancer immunotherapy, we have been working in two directions. First, adoptive transfer of ex vivo expanded canine NK cells, and next, in vivo expansion and stimulation of canine NK cells. For adoptive transfer of ex vivo expanded canine NK cells, we have developed ex vivo expansion system of canine NK cells, and phenotypically and functionally characterize those cells. Recently, we have established a production system for genetically modified CAR NK cells to maximize anti-cancer effect. So for in vivo expansion and the stimulation of canine NK cells, we developed a large scale production system of recombinant canine IL-15 and also production system of canine cyclic denucleotides. We complete clinical trials of cancer therapy using Fox-15, and I would like to present the result of the clinical trial today. So interleukin-15 is a pleiotropic cytokine that can affect both innate and adaptive immune response. So IL-15 promotes development, survival, and activation of various immune cells like dendritic cells, B cells, mast cells, neutrophils. Most importantly, interleukin-15 play crucial roles in the development, homeostasis, and function of CD8 cytotoxic T cell and NK cells. Compared to interleukin-2, IL-15 is more promising, effective, and less toxic for cancer therapy. Unlike IL-2, or IL-15 does not stimulate regulate T cell activation, it's very important. So based on these IL-15 functions, we generated recombinant canine IL-15 for cancer immunotherapy in dogs, and confirmed its effect on canine immune cells in vitro. After that, we performed a preclinical study to evaluate safety and immunological effect of Fox-15 in normal beagle dogs. To examine the safety and effect of Fox-15 administration on the generation and the function of NK cell in dogs, Fox-15 was injected intravenously once a day in doses of 20 microgram per kilogram body weight for 8 days, and monitored for clinical toxicity and adverse effect and immunological effect for 32 days. As a result, there was no adverse effect during and after administration of Fox-15. And the leukocyte population in peripheral blood, especially in lymphocytes, were changed, and the proportion of lymphocyte was significantly increased from day four, and then a return to their baseline level after day 25. These changes in lymphocyte population were due to the increase in CD3 positive, CD5 deem positive, CD20 negative cells, and non-B non-T-NK lymphocytes. Both cell populations was start to increase at day four and reached their peak on day 11, and then return to basal levels after day 25 of injections. Intracellular expression of Ki-67, which is an indicator of cell proliferation, was start to increase at day two, and most of both cell populations were expressing intracellular Ki-67, suggestive of a vigorous proliferation of those cell populations. And most of Ki-67 positive cells were expressing also granzyme B, which is cytotoxic granules. Canine NK cells still defined as non-B, non-T lymphocytes because specific canine NK cell markers have not yet been described. However, a few reports have demonstrated that CD3 positive, CD5 DIM positive lymphocytes are putative canine NK cells. And recently, we reported CD3 positive, CD5 DIM positive cell and non-B non-T cells both contain a subset of NK cells, and the CD5 DIM lymphocyte can be differentiated into non-B non-T NK cells through phenotyping modulation in response to cytokine stimulations. The difference between those two populations may be due to the degree of maturation. So we can conclude that increased lymphocyte population after Fexurkin 15 injections were NK cells. CD8 T cells also increased after injection in the same pattern as NK cells. Importantly, Fexurkin 15 did not stimulate CD4 positive, CD25 positive, POXP3 positive regulated T cell proliferation. And also, Fexurkin 15 did not induce CD4 T cell and B cell proliferations. MRE levels of most NK cell related receptors and genes, including CD16, NKG2D, NCRs, and cytotoxic granules, were significantly increased after Fexurkin 15 injections. So based on this result of preclinical study, we conducted clinical trials of Fexurkin 15 in combination with ultra-low dose cyclophosphamide in dog patients with cancer. Cancer patients were selected based on these patient selection and inclusion criteria. And a total of 15 patients were enrolled in the clinical trials, and the age of these selected dogs was 4 to 17 years old. And 6 hematologic tumors, including lymphoma, and 9 solid cancer patients were included. 3 patients were selected as a control group, and ultra low dose cyclophosphamide alone was administered. So ultra low dose cyclophosphamide was administered daily for 8 weeks. And from day 14 after administration of cyclophosphamide, Fexurkin 15 was intravenously injected for 8 days. And a clinical response and incidence of adverse event during and after drug administration were monitored every day. Blood samples were taken every 7 days before and after injection to confirm hematological and immunological effects. Safety, including adverse event, was evaluated based on these criteria. 3 of 15 cancer patients had a very mild vomiting of grade 1 after bexotin 15 injections, and a very mild fever of grade 1 was observed in a patient. In hematological evaluations, bexotin 15 did not cause any significant changes. And also, bexotin 15 did not cause any significant changes in blood chemistry. So clinically, five out of 15 treated patients with bexotin 15 were partial response with partially reduced cancer size, and five were stable disease, and the remaining five patients continued the tumor progression. As a result, disease control rate of bexotin 15 treatment combined with ultra-low dose cyclophosphamide was about 67%. In comparison, disease control rate was 0% in the control group administered with cyclophosphamide alone. These are photographs of tumor lesions and thoracic radiographs showing changes before and after treatment with bexotin 15 in a patient with advanced lymphoid granulomatosis. The lesions improved markedly after bexotin 15 treatment, and the enlarged suprasternal lymph node, which was observed on thoracic radiographs before treatment, disappeared after bexotin 15 treatment. This slide showing the flow cytometric analysis in peripheral blood of a patient with B cell lymphoma. The B cell population decreased significantly into normal range after completion of bexotin 15 injections. So, prostate ultrasonography of a patient with prostatic gland adenocarcinoma showed a slight decrease in prostatic size after 6 weeks of bexotin 15 treatment. This patient was classified as a stable disease. Abdominal ultrasonography of patient with chronic lymphocytic leukemia showing the splenomegaly, so which showed a very mottled echotexture before treatment was markedly improved 49 days after treatment, resulting in a decrease in the splenic size. And echotexture was also significantly improved compared to before treatment. The immunological responses after bexotin 15 treatment in cancer patients were the same as in normal dogs. NK cell populations and CD8 cells increased after bexotin 15 injections in the same pattern as in normal dogs. So, yeah. Intracellular Ki-67 expression was markedly increased in CD3 positive, CD5 DIM positive cells and NAMB. non-T NK cell populations after bexotin 15 injections, suggestive of vigorous proliferation of this cell population. However, bexotin 15 did not stimulate CD4 positive, 25 positive, PAX-P3 positive regulatory T cell proliferation. Such immunological changes were never observed in cyclophosphamide-only control groups. Despite this anti-cancer effect of vexrucin 15, there were limitations of vexrucin 15 therapies. Anti-cancer effects of vexrucin 15 were temporary. So, and in all patients who responded clinically after vexrucin 15 injection, tumors progressed rapidly after 6 to 8 weeks of injection. For example, these pictures were taken 15 weeks after vexrucin 15 treatment in a patient with advanced lymphoid granulomatosis. As you see, cancer progressed quickly again. So we reconfirmed the preclinical data from normal beagle dogs to develop new protocols for sustaining anti-cancer effect of vexrucin 15. As you can see, intracellular expression of Ki-67 reaches highest peak, and so peak at day 4 after injection, and gradually downregulated, and then return to basal levels 10 days after completion of vexrucin 15 injections. These immunological changes were consistent with clinical response. Based on the preclinical and clinical data, a new protocol of repeated injections every 10 days after the end of 4 consecutive day injections was determined, and new clinical trials has begun. NK cell populations proliferate vigorously with every repeated injections. So NK cell and the tumor volumes are now well maintained at a constant level for 1,339 days since the first injections of vexrucin 15 in a patient with T cell lymphoma. Taken all together, it is concluded that vexrucin 15 is safe and has tremendous potentials for anti-tumor therapy for dogs. Thank you very much.